Many people claim that a larger intermittency in supply has to go with a significant increase in electricity storage. But is this really true? Because actually electricity storage is only one of the possible means that can provide certain services, such as voltage or frequency control, backup capacities or intertemporal arbitrage, and there are many other technologies that can be used in very similar functions, such as a more flexible operation of generating units or also demand-side management with an active demand response. And that's why our report provides policy recommendations for the European Commission on how to provide a level playing field for these alternative means of flexibility, and in particular also on how to allow for the development and deployment of electricity storage.
Each THINK report follows an identical six-month process with two important milestones. The first milestone, after 2 months, is a hearing where the robustness of the preliminary thinking on a topic is tested by industry experts, public authorities, and academics. The second milestone, after 3 months, is a meeting with the THINK Scientific Council to review the first draft of the report.
Today's meeting was meeting of the scientific committee of the THINK project. We were discussing electricity storage. The meeting was, I must say, one of the most interesting meetings of the scientific committee. We had a very good discussion, not only on the specific topic of storage, but on the surroundings of storage, which means in the context of storage, which means the evolution of our electricity systems in Europe. In that respect, I think it clearly showed the value of having such highly qualified people in this committee to provide the necessary input to make sure that the quality of the reports we are producing here in the THINK project are really the highest possible quality.
After the meeting of the Scientific Council, a revised version of the report goes to public consultation. Following this, the report is then finalized.
So we did wonder, for instance, what these drivers for the new interest in electricity storage are. Is electricity storage actually a special class of assets for the future power system? Which conditions might have led to a more successful and more ambitious development and deployment of electricity storage in other non-European countries? What are viable business models for electricity storage? And finally, do the current market design and regulation also allow for these business models in the European power system?